I believe that we all can time travel in our minds through our thoughts. That's called thinking. I wonder how many people actually think. Anyways, I just want to share some thoughts. Thoughts that I think about and thoughts that make me wonder. Like, for example, if everything is made up of atoms, then everything we see is mostly empty space. 99.99% to be precise. So what we actually see is nothing but empty space, and it has somehow arranged itself in a way that it makes sense to us. Then what about our own bodies? Aren't we a collection of atoms too? So we are also 99.99% empty space. And that's when people bring souls into discussion. What are souls? Maybe I'm just a soul who can shrink or expand, and my worldview depends on my thinking. For example, I can think of myself as a subatomic particle, and then I can imagine Earth or the Sun as the nucleus of a subatomic particle, and the Moon or another planets behave as electrons. Or if I focus on myself, I become the center of my universe. That's called living in the head. I introspect so much, as they say in scientific terms, or overthink, as a common man will say, or I meditate and then I realize that I can choose who I want to be. I can be this body as a whole, or I can be one of my senses. Like, I can just observe or just hear or close my eyes and use my sense of touch or smell to get around. It's like an energy ball, the soul. And when I try to suppress oneself, the other senses, they get heightened. So if we imagine water coming out from a pipe and the pipe is closed at the end, and has like 5 holes representing 5 senses, then I put my finger in one of the holes and the water flow increases from other holes. It's the same thing with senses. So if I suppress one sense, my other senses, they get heightened, because there is a continuous energy flow that's happening. So that sounds like a fascinating idea, but see, that's just another thought. There is no tougher question than figuring out the self, and I guess there's nothing more fun to figure oneself out if we start thinking about it. The possibilities are endless, infinite, and so is our universe, as they say. Or maybe there is just one universe and just one us. Maybe we all live in a giant atom's core, or maybe we are like electrons trying to attain a higher level of energy and evolve while the nucleus or the gravity keeps pulling us down. Or if you think that's a lot to think about and you are feeling anxious, then let's just be humans for a while. If everything I said so far feels like a theory, why don't we think in scientific terms? Like, I am a body and I have brain cells, and every decision I made, every thought that I get is transmitted through my body via an extreme network of cells. So what if we start removing one cell at a time? And in the end, we are left with nothing but a brain cell, the most important cell in our body. What if there is only one brain cell and that's the last one, and you think you'll die if it dies? So who are you at that moment? Are you a brain cell, or are you a human? Or are you a tiny packet of energy stored inside the cell, like the nucleus for a cell or a heartbeat for a human? I don't know, it's fun to think about these things, but after a while you will realize that such sort of thought surfing consumes a lot of energy. And in the end, you gotta take a break and go eat something. We gotta feed the body in order for it to work properly. And before I go and grab something to eat, I'll leave you with one last thought. Whom do we feed? Do we feed the body? Do we feed the soul? Are we feeding a machine? Or is it the devil whom we feed so he can spare our life and let us live another day? Or are we feeding the ever-loving nucleus within us? The one that keeps us close to reality and it doesn't allow us to get lost in the endless infinite loop of thoughts. Something which helps us maintain our sanity. Something that keeps us human. Like we are birds who can fly, but in the end we come back to the home. So take some rest and recharge and fly again. And see you next time. Take care, my fellow thought surfers. Thank you.